Hey guys, you're Warwick Repairs, and welcome back to my favorite 16 Brock Coromote, where Herbert last time off I completely defeated Intellect, in the semifinal of the Europa League, and got to the final, which as you can see is going to be against Juventus. And this is actually ironic because this video will be going up on Tuesday, the day before the real-life Europa League final between Liverpool and Seattle. Oh, so, well timed, twin genetic. Imagine if this current video was going up on Wednesday. Hey, Inception. Nah, it's kidding. But yeah, in this episode, as well as the Europa League final, which for some reason the game has placed in White Hart Lane, so it's in England, not in Switzerland, like it should be. I don't even know if the stadium that's hosting the Europa League in this game. Obviously the game's like, if it is, the game's obviously like, nah, that's too small. Which is seemingly a very, is what I've been hearing a lot of the past couple, ever since we won the semifinal tie against Villarreal, is that a lot of the Liverpool fans are going over regardless of whether they have tickets or not. And fair play to him. If I had the time and the money, yeah, I would definitely go myself. Oh, of course. Yeah, can't. But hopefully, the next time Liverpool are in Europe, I'll be there. That's one of the things you have to see in your lifetime is a European match, let alone a final. Just seeing a European match, to be at Anfield and experience like the amazing atmosphere that. And, was well on display against Borussia Dortmund and against Villarreal. Well, it was amazing.
Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. Chiellini.
Sandro Hansen. Oh, Hansen doubles our lead. Hansen, who needs a hat trick to in this final to get the goal, the top goal scorer award from Traore, has now leveled with Traore. They're both on 10. So if Hansen scores one more goal and Traore doesn't score her in the rest of this match, Hansen will get top goal scorer. And up until the last episode, Hansen had never scored a hat trick all season. All of a sudden, now he might get two in two episodes. This is, who are you and what have you done with Hansen? You're not Amen Hansen. Amen Hansen doesn't score this many goals. Not for me, anyway. Maybe he does for the real life Braga, but I don't know, I don't really follow the Portuguese league.
Now they've won the ball back and trying to make something of it quickly.
Piano. Another defensive error from Juventus. Ooh. I don't know why I tried that.
A got the ball in the middle of the pitch here.
Bolly. So, it's looking good that I'm going to win the Europa League.
He's kept it out. And a corner.
And then I found something out between this and the last. The Braga Corona video. You guys remember how I said that I'll be doing Feyenoord next? And I am still going to be doing Feyenoord, but I found out that Feyenoord didn't qualify for the Champions League or the Europa League. They're not in any European competition, so I won't have any European competition in my next career mode. It'll be just the league and the cup.
Couple of tricks, drop the shoulder, and he's away.
And while I'm not having the Europa League, he gets kind of a upside, not having any European football whatsoever. It's a bit of a downer, really.
Decent block. Lucio tries the volley.
But it'll probably be a shorter career mode, if I'm being honest. Because there'll be less games. European games add something to the... add a bit of mystique to the...
awarded the free kick.
Who, the career modes. And having won European competition in all my career modes, looks like I won the Champions League with Juventus and Dortmund and, Gladbach. And I won both the Champions League and Europa League with Liverpool. And I'm looking good to keep that run going here with Braga. I can't continue it with Feyenoord because they're not in it. So, yeah.
And here's the shot. That's very straightforward. Well, one team going off happy.
Half-time. Scoreline is going well. We'll continue that in the second half, and the Europa League will be in the trophy cabinet alongside the league title. And hopefully the cup. That's a foul there, a ref. If that will be a yellow card, please. It's for 37. Yeah, I was wondering what was taking them so long. Pereira. We didn't get a lot of playing time under me. Actually, I think I sold him, didn't I? I might have sold him. I know I sold Morata. I bought a play much better. See, Hansen, that was almost you. Luckily, you actually performed better than A1 Ray. It's Morata, good for you.
Jabba.
Hansen. Ah. Gonna be there throw. I'll give Bonucci credit, that was good defensive work from the Italian. And I rammed into the defender, which is probably gonna be a foul. No? Hansen for the hat trick! Would you believe he scored a second one? Before the last episode, he hadn't scored a hat trick all season. He scored only two goals.
For him, a hat-trick.
I could probably count on one hand how many games he had two goals, had scored braces in, but in consecutive episodes, he bagged that trick in consecutive episodes,
he's pretty much it's guaranteed that I'm going to win the Europa League era Braga. And he is now the top goal scorer in the Europa League, having passed Traore with the hat-trick that he needed. It's crazy, isn't it? Well, of course, he needs Traore not to score for the remainder of the match. And here he is. Oh, he's missed. He's missed.
Difficult one because there was a couple of yards in it, I think.
Oh, he was offside. Ah, still, it was a pretty bad miss, to be honest. Wait, Kadira just came on. What are you smoking, King? Who? This guy's terrible. How did he get Juventus? I mean, he got Juventus in the Europa League final. I won the Champions League with this team. Plus, if one or two. Who additions, but mostly with this team. You got to the Europa League final. I mean, you got knocked out of the Champions League in the group stages. This guy is terrible. Sack this guy. I don't care if he got to the Europa League final. No? The fact that he couldn't get out of the group stages when I won the Champions League. We're pretty much the same team. Like I said, only two or three signings.
Keep the side in possession. That's a good challenge. Cuadrado.
He should be doing way better. It should have been quarterfinalist at least. Not knocked out in the group stages. This is Juventus.
For Juventus, so far down.
As we're talking about here, one of the best teams in Italy, some would say the best, mainly because they keep winning in the league. Even this season, when it looked like they weren't going to win the league, but when they started off doing similar to Chelsea, except unlike Chelsea, they recovered and were like, oh, wait, hang on a second, we're Juventus, we have to win the league.
Excellent.
Crushing the hearts of every fan and of other teams like Roma, Napoli, AC Milan, Inter Milan, any other team you can think of who might have challenged for the title. Sorry! Oh, would you believe? Who was that? Who the hell? How did he miss that? Who was that? I think it was Neves. Yeah, it was Ruben Neves. How did you miss that header, dude? Well, there's your fucking problem. You're playing Mario Mandzukic over Paulo Dybala. Are you fucking for real? You're definitely getting the Zach Knight. And you're bringing him on in the 90th minute. You're 3-0 down. You're 3-0 down. You bring your best goal scorer on at the end of the match. At 3-0 back. You don't... I know you're getting the sack. He's definitely getting the sack. Because that is not on. The fact that he played Mario Mandzukic over... That's... No. No. Be surprised if he got sacked on the spot. If I was the owner of Juventus, I'd be at the game in cold hands like, you're fired. Fuck off. What an utter dumbass. I'd be expecting to get a call in the next couple of days. It's from the owner for asking me to come back. Anyway, the last game of this league game of the season, Porto beat the second team 3-1. It doesn't really matter because the league was won ages ago. So thanks to the fact that Porto couldn't beat Sporting, so just for that part. Oh, despite the fact that you beat me, you're the reason I won the league in the first place. So there's. Cheers. I don't know why I said tears. Yeah, tears. They're crying. What a bunch of babies. It's get over it. Three players are tied for top goal scorer in this competition. Jonas, Gaetano of Benfica, and Abel Hernandez. Maybe I'll bring Abel Hernandez on at some point. He is on the bench. Maybe he'll make an appearance to perhaps get all that would give him the top goal scorer for the cup. But of course, the main focus is to win the cup. So here we go.
The exact same match that I just simmed in the league. This time I'll be playing it, and this time is going to be a different result.
I mean, it could easily be 3-1 again, but I don't think it's going to be 3-1 to Porto.
Just an inkling. See, the goal scorer against Porto, I think, if I remember correctly, it was Hernandez in the league match that I said. It might have been. I'll have to look back to that. Obviously, this spell will be after the match, when it'll be pointless. Ruben Neves taken out by their former teammate. That is disgraceful. Early yellow card for Herrera. Hector Herrera, not Manchester United. Ooh! That was going in! I think that was going in! But I forced the save! Hell yeah! Best free kick I've ever had! I think it might have been going in. At least it was on target. I'll take that. I'll take getting it on target. I don't normally get them on target. In fact, I never. Not...
Fair play to him for having a crack. Well, he really could be the star of the show today. Three in his last three games.
And since the man to watch.
Pereira.
Of course, obviously, they're talking about how he scored a hat trick, a second hat trick in two games. If only he just wasn't the end of the goddamn career. Mode, or I'd be delighted because he'd be showing great form. Unfortunately, this is my last game as Braga manager. Frick, he saved the best for last. That's typical. Of course, it's one of the players I had he criticized all season. He decides, better show the manager what I'm capable of in his last few games. Because logic, of course, you know, total logic. Oh boy, can Hansen score again? Oh, great save by Iker Casillas. Did Hansen even connect with that, or was that just Rodriguez passing it to Casillas? You know, all Real Madrid teammates, he's having a front, he passing a ball. What was that?
You know, Hansen and Timmans, could you stand around and do less? Perhaps. You know? You pretty much watch the ball go past them. Is what you think I understand and their new jobs to be. I didn't know I never told them to do this. It's not what I had in mind. I had in mind to get some goals. Win the goddamn trophy, and then on a goddamn high, but He having won a treble. Oh, the first treble in Bra. History. The fact that I've won the Europa League with them. The fact that I've won the league with them. The first ever time that I've won the league. But no. Apparently, my players want to stand around and do fuck all. If they're gonna piss me off, you know, they're picking the best time to do it, when there's nothing I can do about it. Oh, I can still sub them off, but I only have 3 substitutions. And I don't plan to use them right now.
The player's done well here, until it was the direction of the pass, really. Right idea, but find his man, it's over the touchline.
Excuse me. Sorry. I don't know why I'm sneezing.
The opposition backed off, they could be in trouble. And the ball gets to here. They're going
actually,
to tries to punch it away.
Actually, brings me to, I don't know why that reminds me, but about yesterday, you may have noticed there was no Game of Thrones review for episode 4, and there was no finale to the Assassin's Creed playthrough. Well, Assassin's Creed playthrough, I'm going to have to replay the whole damn game in order to get you that last video, because I played the game, I finished it, I recorded it, but something went wrong with my Elgato, and I lost the footage. So, I'm gonna, having already deleted the game, reinstalled Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, because, of course, that's what was gonna follow Assassin's Creed 2. Oh, now, I'm gonna delete Brotherhood, because I can't have both on this history, because I haven't got the room for both. Oh, I'm going to have to reinstall Assassin's Creed 2, play through a whole game in between now and next Monday until I get to the point where I was. Yes, which is going to be a pain in the ass. Yes, and
who's going to hold up the Taça de Portugal,
then record the video. So I'm going to play through parts of the game up until next Monday, and so on. Well, I should relatively get through quickly. I'll have plenty of time when I'm not recording videos.
Not everything he's tried has come off.
Didn't quite have the impact I was expecting at the start, but time to remedy that.
I can actually play a lot of it tomorrow before the final. After I record my last video, of course. As for the Game of Thrones, which, of course, I don't record with the Elgato, I record that my face cam on my laptop. What happened there was, when I went to look for the episode 4, I went out to the site where I watched the episodes. I went on, I scrolled down to the season 6, episode 1 was there, episode 2 was there, episode 3 was there, but episode 4, for some reason, was not there. Episode 4 wasn't put up on the site for some reason. So, hopefully, it's been put up there between now and then, and you'll get the Game of Thrones review. I'll be a little late, but you'll get it tomorrow. So you'll get 2 videos tomorrow. So, the Game of Thrones review will probably be relatively early in the morning, maybe about 10:30, I don't know, or something like that. That's a penalty, thank you very much.
Well, it's a penalty, and the referee's added.
And this is the perfect time to introduce Mr. Abel Hernandez. I know Henson did score that opening goal, but Hernandez has the chance to be the top goal scorer. So Hansen's time as my player is officially over. But we will not see out the rest of this game. We'll still get his mount.
He's attacked it well, and it's a composed first-time finish.
Decent goal. Sorry, Yuri, but it's going to have to be Ewan Hernandez. Can he get the goal to make him the top goal scorer? Oh, great save from Ingrid Casillas. And I couldn't stop my player. I knew he would do that. It was Tillemans. To spite me, you prick.
We can tell he knows the game.
Actually, that's a fun Tillemans' nest with me, I suppose. So, oh well, yeah, you're Tillemans, you're her Braga Kurimo, your career at Braga is over. You can go back to Anselak as probably a triple win, or I have to leave. Oh, unless Porto can get back in this game and after that. But I don't normally concede the lead. And here we go. Foul. Tillemans leaving the pitch. And Augusta will play out the rest of this final.
That's dealt with the problem. Well, the pressure's on again with another corner.
And Tillemans will still get his medal.
He's got his fist to it.
At the end of the game.
That wasn't a very good decision to shoot from there.
Oh, collective groans right around the stadium. And some looks of disgust from teammates.
Sorry. I pressed circle to tackle, and the game thought I was trying to shoot. Was when I didn't have the...
Garner.
To press...
Hector Herrera.
X. Or so this thing I'm trying
to... Layoud.
Don't shoot it. Don't shoot it.
Still time to change this game.
You rip it.
Plenty of long balls.
Great ball. And that is on to it. This is it. This is your second chance. Oh, Casillas again with a fantastic save.
Yeah, very close. I think we could probably tell that without even looking at the figures. Not much to
spare. First time could be the charm. Rodriguez. Well, using that handle. Let's stick to my advantage. Rodriguez. Hernandez! And he missed! Able man! This is your opportunity!
Traore. Got past his marker. At full extension, the goalkeeper makes the save.
Hernandez. Can't do anything right!
Time to go.
I'm so angry, man. I accidentally turned on FIFA Trainer. Put the ball in the back of the net, you daft tit. Rodriguez. Traore.
That's a good challenge between
Gusto. Santos. Hernandez. Probably gonna be your last opportunity. And it's not gonna happen.
Abu Bakr. Layoud. Free kick in these closing minutes.
Free kick. They're not gonna do anything with this free kick. And let's stand up here in case we get a counter attack. But as soon as I clear the ball, it's probably gonna be game over. Yep, there it is. As soon as I kicked it. It's 1-0, Hansen gets the glorious being not only the guy who won the Europa League, but he got the winning goal in the cup. Would you freaking believe it? It's a freaking course. There you go.
What can you do?
Some people will just surprise you. 4 goals in the last 2 games. and he won two trophies for me. Curiosity. 33 goals in all competitions, including the 5 that he got at the start of the season. I mean, that's only 4 less than Traore. But Traore played much better. I mean, look at the difference in the differences in the league goals. 26-15. A whole 11 goals in it. 11! Albeit he beats him in every other competition. He beats him in the Attack Portugal 2-1. 10-11 in the Europa League. Traore's got more assists! Imagine that! Somehow Traore got more assists. Albeit by 1. And Charlie got more clean sheets. I'm not sure how he did that. Tenth. Dude, that was your last hit. And you won in a triple. What were you upset about? Probably because he didn't get
the top goal score.
Oh well. What indeed can you do? So, that is it for Portugal. Next up, Holland. For a bit of smoke out of that cake. I'm just kidding. But, why not? When in Amsterdam, or wherever Feyenoord is. I don't know. Like I said, I don't. Like I said, as much as I don't follow the Portuguese league, I don't follow the Dutch league either. So, what can you do? But, in the next, on Saturday, you'll see the beginning of the Feyenoord career mode. Until then, and thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this lengthy and crazy run with SC Braga. Until next time, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Until next time, I hope you all have a very